So, as you can see here, I changed the API URL from the API that we have created to the proxy to do a function that we have created that's playing the role of a proxy. I have started the project, and if you can see here, it's on localhost, and I am going to try and add a new task. So, let's write space X. And hi, let's create. Great, let's go back to the list. It's here. And if we go to the ASVI function that we have created to do the create, you can see that we have the logs here, and you can see that the application was called and it was run successfully, it succeeded. And we have right now the items inside our application. Now, one more thing we need to do is we are going to push the client application to Azure. And right now, we don't need to worry about any changes we do to our API. Everything we need to do, we can change it from the proxy. And we can keep this proxy link here inside the client application, and we don't need to change it at all. So we don't have to worry about it. Okay, let's push our backend, our client actually, sorry, our client application. So publish. Oh. Yes, publish. We are going to wait a couple of seconds. This is gonna take a couple of seconds here. And if we finish this, we can say that we have finished it, all this part. The Azure function that will play as a proxy and the Azure function create. The next step will be is to add the application insights. Okay, the application now is pushed to Azure. Let's wait. Okay, the application right now is online. Let me do a couple of modification. Let's, for example, add online Azure medium and create. Now it's being created. Let's go back to the list here, and it's been created. Let's go to Azure function. A new one have been executed. A new code is executed, and you have created a new task using the Azure function and not the API. Great. So right now, after we have created the application, the one more step to do is to add the application inside so we can understand the life cycle of the application, if there is any errors or the traffic and the request time for the application. So first we are going to add the application insights, and later we are going to see some DevOps to better work with our client part and API. So let's go.